Hello everyone, I am Dr. Anubhuti Sood and I'm an oral pathologist currently working as a research officer in VMMC and Safdarjung Hospital. So the topic that I'm going to present today is role of machine learning in forensic odontology a systematic review. Now, actually, everybody here knows that there are several existing forensic investigation procedures which are currently based on the subjective interpretation of the investigators. And there are several novel techniques that are attempting to replicate the human thinking or the human brain so that there can be increased accuracy and there can be reduction of the error rates. Now, some of these techniques are included under the spectrum of artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. So before we move further into the presentation, it is important to understand these three terms. Artificial intelligence refers to the technique which enables the machines to mimic human behavior or human brain. Machine learning refers to a subset of artificial intelligence which uses statistical methods to enable machines to improve with experience. However, it is a simple learning technique. In case of the deep learning technique, deep learning method, this basically refers to the computation of multi-layered neural network in which the machines, they learn by themselves upon their experience and improve their error rates as and when their performance increases. So there are actually several examples of the machine learning in our day-to-day life. The most common being the speech recognition systems, which are indicative in the Siri and the Alexa systems in our iPhone and Android phones. Then we have the image recognition capabilities that are by the virtue of machine learning in our phones, again, which allow the facial features to be detected in our phones to get unlocked. In field of forensics, the machine learning applications have been used for facial authentication, image processing techniques, radiographic image analysis, pattern evidence analysis. So since this is an upcoming trend in the field of forensic odontology, the authors of the present systematic review attempted to identify the areas of its utilization and evaluation, and they attempted to evaluate their advantages and limitations in the field of forensic odontology. The present review consisted of a data search in which a Boolean search was performed in the major databases of PubMed, Medline, Google Scholar, Web of Science, and Cochrane. The various keywords consisted of machine learning, deep learning, artificial intelligence, convolutional neural networks, and so on, as the list has been given on your screens. The next, it included transportation of the various citations into the Zotero citation manager, in which the duplicates were removed, followed by the title and abstract search via a web-based application, that is Ryan QCR application. Full-length text screening was then performed, with keeping in mind the inclusion and exclusion criteria as well as the PICO criteria that were defined for this study. Following that, data extraction was done. A critical analysis or a risk of bias analysis was performed via QuADRS2 tool, and which was followed by a qualitative analysis. So the PICO that was defined for this study was all the studies that had been conducted in the field of forensic odontology in which the machine learning or the deep learning models had been used as an intervention and had been compared to standard references and which had measurable outcomes in terms of accuracy, precision, mean error, specificity, sensitivity, AUC, ROC, correlation coefficients, and F1 score were included. All the studies that were included in the present systematic review should have fulfilled the PICO criteria, should have explicit mentioning of the machine learning model that was used, and should have had measurable outcome. All these studies that were in language other than English were conference abstracts, review articles, were on topics other than forensic odontology, studies for whom the full-length articles were not available, they were excluded from this current systematic review. The initial records indicated that we obtained 932 records from the initial databases. Following the removal of the duplicates, that is 608 duplicates, we screened 324 articles for title and abstract, following which 269 records were excluded. 55 reports were then sought for retrieval, that is full-length analysis, out of which 6 we were not able to retrieve. So 49 were assessed for their eligibility according to the inclusion and the exclusion criteria that was set for the study, and out of which 14 were then included in the review. A QuADRS2 tool, that is an online diagnostic test accuracy tool, is available for doing the risk of bias analysis, was done for the 14 studies. Out of the 14 studies, 3 studies were the one which showed questionable risk of bias. So after a discussion amongst the co-authors, these studies were then excluded from the systematic review. Our major findings included identification of major areas in which the machine learning had been applied. That is 53% of the studies in forensic odontology applied machine learning for gender estimation. 29% for age estimation, 12% for human identification, and 6% for ancestry estimation. These studies were primarily based on the identification of the radiographic landmarks, either via OPG or CBCD, primarily via the OPG images, and their interpretation via the neural networks. Now, the term neural network is consistently associated with the artificial intelligence, machine learning, or the deep learning. So we will be using this term again and again. The included studies reported higher accuracy than the conventional methods, which usually fell in the range between 75 to 100%. We even identified the most appropriate machine learning algorithm for gender and age estimation, as well as the ancestry estimation, that was the support vector mechanism of the machine learning algorithm. The various strengths that were identified for the machine learning tools were having higher accuracy, having a time-saving component after the training and the validation had been done for these algorithms, and it also minimizes the human bias, which was the major reason for conducting these studies. The limitations that were identified were having a black box status, which essentially means that all the machine learning algorithms in the artificial intelligence, in all these algorithms, we can actually detect or we can see the input and the output, but the investigator is unable to judge the bias or the basis on which the judgment calls are taken by these algorithms. So hence, this issue is referred to as the black box issue in the artificial intelligence, which remains as such in case of the field of forensic odontology as well. There is a requirement of large training and validation data sets for tuning of these algorithms. Tuning processes, which actually means maximizing the efficiency of these machining algorithms, is also quite cumbersome and it may be unpredictable. We also observed that human versus machine workflow, with respect to its time, they have not been compared, and they have not been detailed in any of these studies. Out of all the studies that were included in the systematic review, one of the most important studies that was based on the age group determination in living individuals using the first four molars, which has been recently published in 2021 by Kim et al, actually stated that unlike human observations and conventional dental age estimation methods that use only specific individual features, the AI-based age group estimation model has the overwhelming strength of using comprehensive and automatic judgment of various anatomical factors. So to conclude, that even though the artificial neural networks, they are independent of human bias, they have a higher accuracy, precision, and recall, we do suggest that the final decisions regarding a forensic case be humanly supervised. That is, machine learning or deep learning based approaches be limited to supplemental or assisting the final outcome, with the final validation being humanly supervised. This is very akin to how we use the immunohistochemistry in the field of oral pathology, that it is always used for supplementing the findings of the an oral pathologist. We also had the opportunity of finding the various research fields, a potential research field through this research, that is investigation of the data mining process in the forensic odontology, conducting the machine learning based population studies in different regions, and creation of a common worldwide database for improved accuracy and reference for various forensic odontologists. It is to be noted that currently the machine learning based studies have been conducted in only certain populations, that is European, Caucasians, Brazilians, and only in India, it only exists in a South Indian population that is also very region based. So this is a great potential. This is a field where great potential exists and further studies can be conducted. So I will conclude with the demonstration of all my references and thanking the organizers for their opportunity, and also acknowledging my co-authors as well as Mr. Sanidhya Manoj, the Associate Director at Analytics at WNS Global Services, for his technical expertise regarding the technical terms of artificial intelligence. I would also like to bring attention of the listeners to this final pictographic image, which actually brings out the process of the machine learning. That is, even though we are going to take the final decision, the machine learning process always knows our decision in advance. So perhaps in future, if the machine learning processes are advanced enough, we might be able to come to a conclusion of competitions like this before the judges can actually give their final outcome. Thank you so much for the opportunity.